element number 5, variation of deflection of a simply supported beam. The main objective of this practical is to study the variation of the deflection of a simply supported beam with the material type, beam thickness and the applied load. Verification of the theory. First, consider the pure bending equation. Bending moment over the second moment of inertia about the bending axis equal to the bending stress at distance y from the neutral axis equal to the modulus of the elasticity over the radius of the curvature. Take this equation as equation 1. Next, take a look at this equation. It tells that 1 over radius of a beam is equal to the second derivative of the deflection of the beam with respect to the deflection measuring distance from the selected origin of the beam. Take this equation as 2. By using equation 1, it can derive that 1 over r equals to m over e into I. It can apply to the equation 2 and get this equation. Here, bending moment can be replaced by applied load into the distance from the origin. Then it can obtain this equation. But we need to find the relationship between the deflection to the above explained variables. To do that, we have to double integrate this equation with respect to x. After integrate one time, we can get this equation. Here, C1 is a constant. Then integrate another time and we can get this equation. Here, also C2 is a constant. Now, we have a relationship between the deflection of a simply supported beam with applied load, modulus of elasticity and second moment of inertia. Modulus of elasticity means the material type and the second moment of inertia means the dimensions of the beam. These C constant values are depend on the support conditions and the load applied conditions of the beam. For this practical, simply supports are applied at 1/4 span of the total length of the beam from both ends of the beam and load is applied at the middle point. When consider these support conditions, dz over dx equal to 0 at the middle point and the deflection will be 0 at the support points. You can apply these values for equation 3 and 4 and find the values for C constants according to our practical support conditions. After applying the values for C constants, you can simplify the equation 4 and get an equation similar to this one. In your report, for your theory part, you have to find the A value according to our practical support conditions. As you can see, if you are not changing the beam, this equation has y equal mx type graph. You have to plot graphs for all the tested beams with deflection and the applied load and get an idea how the deflection vary with the load. Next, you have to consider the gradient of the graph. You can replace I like this. Here, the gradient and 1 over cubic thickness of the beam also has a relationship according to y equal mx type. Now you have to plot a graph with the gradient of the same material beams with 1 over cubic thickness of the beams. At last, if you are not changing the thickness of the beams but the material type, then the relationship again will be like this. Gradient and 1 over modulus of elasticity has relationship according to y equal mx. Again, you have to plot a graph with gradient of the same thickness being with 1 over modulus of elasticity of the beam. From those graphs, you can study how deflection of a simply supported beam is vary with the applied load, material type, and the thickness of the beam.